future trends, deep insights, industry leaders. This is the iGaming Next podcast with your host, Heidi Lofthus.
Hi, David, not David.
No, we do this in English, right?
Exactly. So this is actually the first podcast in this channel that I do in English with a Swedish person.
Aha, yeah. Nice.
And that, David, happens to be you, the first employee and co-owner of Refapp.
That's right. Hi.
Hi. Over to you. Tell us about yourself.
All right. Yeah, I'm a three children husband. I'm father of three kids. I live in Gothenburg in West Sweden. And I've been working with recruitment last 12, 13 years, I think. And 5 years ago, we realized that doing reference checks, is common in the recruitment process, especially in the Nordics, was not really that, it didn't work. It didn't work at all, how we did it. We tried to, in the society we live in today, where everyone is on demand. We do this podcast, not live. We do it during work hours because that's what we can do. Mm-hmm. And I look at TV, for instance. I look at the news when my kids are asleep. So the on-demand society didn't fit into how we did reference checks, because I worked as a recruiter and I tried to do the reference checks during my working hours. And the referees, they didn't want to talk to me during that hours. And of course, we all are also bombed or called up with a lot of salespeople. We don't answer the phone when someone tried to call you. So
it was really calling.
Yeah, it's aggressive calling. Yeah, that's unfortunately what's happened the last 5-10 years maybe. So we really had a problem working with the reference checks, and we realized this is a process that we should digitalize, and that's what we've done in the last 5 years.
So you're referring to the Nordics, and the traditional way of reference taking is by phone, right? So if you, as a recruiter, you're calling local Nordic countries, you have a recognized country code calling. So it's still it's still aggressive that you call, but it's kind of expected and it's familiar in terms of the recognized phone code.
Yeah.
Many a times I have been called from one of these call center reference checking machines. You know, they call from one of those very unrecognized country codes, Singapore, Malaysia, or anywhere where you wouldn't expect. So they kind of have to prepare you that we will call you to take a reference checks. And it's very unsmooth and it gets very not personalized. I just wanted to put that in there. That is a very, it's not even the right recruiter calling. It's someone else. So it's the phone call is getting even more aggressive with outside Europe phone calls.
Okay. Yeah. I'm not that familiar with that, but of course I got some phone calls from global companies try to sell stuff to me, and that doesn't work that well on me anyway. So
no, exactly.
And that's really also a problem, that even if they know that I would call, they didn't answer, because in the Nordics anyway, and I think now when we're going global, we see that reference checking is quite very common, but also we take it seriously. We like to help our our candidates to get the job. So we are willing to answer the phone, but it's hard to do that. We're stuck in work. We're in meetings all the time. We are not able to do that on working hours. And that was really the biggest problem, I would say, when I tried to call my referees, because they didn't want to talk with me during work hours. So I worked a lot of overtime when it comes to reference checking.
All right. So here we go. Some backgrounds on the problems in reference taking. People don't want to take up phone calls in the middle of the working day, so it's a tedious process, right?
Yeah. It's extremely time consuming as well. Yeah, I didn't talk about that now, but that's a huge problem as well, because what I looked into when we started this was, where do we lose time, where are our process very time consuming? Because I didn't talk about my working background before, but I've been working within the recruitment and staffing agencies last 10 years, and the last years I was recruitment processes in Sweden, and I had a really huge demand to become more efficient in our processes, because hiring prices wasn't that easy to do. Then we need to be more efficient. Mm-hmm. And when I calculated on that, reference checking was really time consuming for our recruiters. Mm-hmm. So that was also a big challenge, or what I saw when we started Refapp, that this is really something that we can help our recruiters to save time.
Mm-hmm. You have also been talking with me about bias and non-bias. So what happens in those phone calls or in that kind of the old traditional process?
Yeah, that was because I won't dig too deep into this, but I am very also, I love validity to what we do when we do in this case, in the recruitment. I need to know, is there validity? Can we prove that this is a good way of doing things? And there is a lot of science in recruitment about all different steps in recruiting. And when it comes to reference checking, the validity doesn't seem too good compared to doing structured interviews, doing assessments, logical tests, etc. Mm. So, but my appearance was that everyone is doing reference checks, and there are some studies now that shows that we do reference checks in 97% of the recruitment in the Nordics, I would say now. But it's quite common also in other big countries we see. So why do we do that then if the validity isn't too good? And that was quite interesting. So I've done some studies and we cooperate with a psychometrics about that, and what we realized then is that one big thing why the validity is not increasing is due to bias, because a big problem, since we do reference checking quite late in the recruitment process, we have a gut feeling about the candidate, and that gut feeling doesn't help us to do right decisions. We try what we hear doesn't affect our brain, because what our gut feelings already is actually our decisions. Yeah. And that is a problem when we have a lot of gut feelings due to the process the recruitment process has been quite long. We do the reference check in the end of the process.
All right, so with all this as a background, and with all this kind of ache in you and your colleagues, you digitalized the entire process, and that's Refapp.
Yeah, exactly. So we built a software as a service to help our clients to either book a phone call, because that we still doesn't think that digital reference checking it must be that way all the time. Sometimes you need to take the call, and that we can help you with. Luckily, our clients think that's only good in 6-7% of the reference checkings right now. So, most of our clients really do digital reference checks. And the process is that the recruiter invite the candidate to collect the referee's contact information, the name, email address, phone number, the relationship, when and where did they work. And then we are able to do a really automated process based on, we send out email and text message to the to the referees after collecting the candidate information with a questionnaire that is based on what the recruiter would like to have, or if they like to use our templates that is validated, that we basically have created based on what is science saying about this type of how to do the best reference checking.
It sounds,
and when the referee says,
it just sounds very simple. I'm thinking, are you the only one on the market doing this?
No, absolutely not. But we invented the Nordic market in a way, I would say, or made it quite common in a way. But there are some colleagues or competitors in Australia and in where reference checking is more common than it is here in Sweden, and also some American companies. But of course, due to our success, we also got some competitors now in Sweden and in the Nordics as well.
So you're exactly how active are you? You joined in 2018. What has happened in the 4 years? Where are you and who are you with?
Yeah. The first 2 years was quite hard. We did scale up, but our clients or the HR and recruiters, they were still into this. It's important with our gut feelings. We need to read between the lines in our reference checking. So it was quite hard to scale up quickly. But the last 2 years, it's gone really fast, I would say. So today we are 36 employees in five different countries, in Sweden, Norway, Finland, Germany, and Dublin. So from Dublin, we have a sales team operating the rest of the world, or the rest of Europe for now. So we have clients in 19 different countries, I would say, and 650 plus clients right now, but we are growing 2 or 3 clients a day right now. So when this is out, maybe we have 700 clients. I don't know.
This makes me, you know, you're referring to the Nordics. How different is, what's the difference in the, in the various countries in terms of reference checking culture?
Yeah. We have seen some differences, I would say. In the Nordics, competency-based recruitment has been very popular for a few years. So that means that you, and that's very much thanks for the pre-employment test companies that help the recruiters to provide a job profile based on the behaviors. Because science says that behavior is very important. What behavior you have is very important to be able to produce good in your next job. And that's been very popular in the Nordics now then to ask questions about behaviors in the reference checking. But that we see isn't that common in the rest of Europe, because then it's more of a check. We just need to check, did you really work at that place at that time? Because a reference check is the only step, I would say, that where we are communicating with some other one than the candidate in the process. So it's quite fair that we want to have that check. And in not too many recruitments, we also do more of a background check. You also check your crime history and credit history and stuff like that. But that is not something we provide today, because the reference check is the most common process within background checks. So that is the check of the employment is more what the main goal is with the reference checks in outside Nordic, I would say. But we're trying to get this competence-based reference check into those countries as well. And it seems like they like it. Mm-hmm. So and of course, most recruiters understand and know about that behavior is important. So why don't ask the referees about
exactly when
the behavior.
When you're at it.
Yeah, exactly.
Are you? So we operate in the gaming industry. We satellite communications and content around the gaming industry. Do you know anything about? Do you have any intel in terms of reference taking within our industry, which is quite, if I'm referring to Malta specifically, quite incestuous. Many people have been with many companies. So I can, you know, I can imagine that reference taking is both on a professional level, but also on a personal level, because you tend to get to know the people outside of the working place as well.
Yeah.
Are you familiar with the gaming industry?
Absolutely. Yeah, we have a few clients within in your industry, especially the. The what you call it, Statlig.
The governmental,
Sweden. The governmental,
the
In Sweden, you know, are very, we have a lot of laws. That's why gaming industry is at other countries. Mm-hmm. But that is one customer. But what we realized is we have a lot of other industries where security of the recruitment is quite important. It's the gaming industry handles a lot of money, so you need to do some securement checks within your recruitment. And by that, we see that digital reference checking is a more secure way of doing reference checking than just ask on the phone, are you really that guy or girl that worked together with that person? Because we integrate with electronic ID confirmation. So we have a seamless integration with, in the Nordics, then bank ID and other countries. We look to find that way also to identify that this is the real referee. And that's, of course, is important. Mm-hmm. And we also do some checks due to the IP address and what email and phone number you have to see that you don't answer on behalf of someone else. Because that was a real problem as well as a recruiter, I would say. Because I made the call. Maybe in Sweden, it's quite easy to look up a phone number. Mm. But nowadays, the phone number isn't written on you as a person. It's, you have your collect, what do you call it, content. Anyway, you cannot identify someone by the phone number. And since we make a phone call, I don't do any ID check on that referee. I couldn't know if the referee was the right person to speak to. And we know based on not any, haven't seen any studies based on that, but some insights from our customers. They say that this is a problem sometimes that you cheat on the references, that they are not who they say they are.
This is... I mean, it's from the candidate. We want to help the candidate getting as true data as possible and positive data. So it's a game, isn't it?
Yeah.
You have on both sides. You have to know the rules, basically.
Absolutely. Yeah, and that's also something that we would like to develop and help our clients to do the reference checks better in many ways. Who do you choose as a referee, etc. And then sorry.
I read an article that our common contact detail Eric, he worked with your company, he wrote an article the other day about him testing your product for the first time. And
Been a manager for a while, and of course, it was said, you need to use the product now when you're recruiting.
Exactly.
Because actually, he was really, yeah, but shouldn't I call? Not at all. You really should do this digital when you work for us. But so, yeah, go on.
Yeah, no, so he wrote a blog about it. Yep. Or an article about it. And so I thought that there were a few things that I wanted to sort of reference check with you, to cross check that. And he's referring to the time.
Yeah.
Right. And I mean, this, David, could easily turn into a sales call for you. But I'm more interested in getting out to the HR, my HR people in the industry to sort of see, for them to scrutinize their own processes.
Yeah.
Time-wise, instead of putting all the administrative time on phone calling, scheduling calls so that you're not these the aggressive person just calling out of the blue. So from four hours to 3 minutes, he says.
Yeah.
Is that?
Yeah, that could be a case, absolutely, and absolutely, it was his what he felt like when doing this. Now I criticized him a little bit about, you did just use our template. You didn't look into the job profile, what I'm looking for, change the questions based on the job profile. But that is also good for us to know, because I'm a bit nerd in this. I when I do my reference checks, I would like to do it very, very structured based on the requirement profile. But he's a traditional manager, and this is what most of us, people that do reference checks, are the managers. Yeah. And then it is a really good help, because doing reference checks for a manager, that's so little of their usually work hours that they put on, and it's just something that I heard, that it's just, oh, now I need to do that. Okay. Someone thinks it's funny. Someone thinks it's just something that HR required them to do. But it also, when you don't train on this, because this is an experience of mine, that when I did reference checks, I would say that being good in doing reference checks, that's quite hard, because I would say it's probably the hardest process step in the recruitment process to do good, because because I don't know the background of the referee when I call him or her. I don't know in what situation he or she is, and I really need to drive the phone call. And that could be hard, and also do it a structured way, and do it with questions that are not too open or not too
And earn trust in the beginning of the phone call.
Your questions. Yeah, exactly. So that was really something that we see is important when we're helping our clients to actually provide them with templates that are good. These are good questions. They are validated, and this is something that the industry think are good questions. And also all the hunting for the candidate and the referees to do the actual, so absolutely, he put 3 minutes into Refapp to just set up the project, the job profile, and then everything went automatically, and he got a report in his email to read it.
Just an interpretation now from my side.
Yeah.
So Eric, the typical manager, using the templates that's in the system, you with your nerdy and also, you know, 15 years of recruitment background, are you the one actually doing the templates that Eric then uses?
Or absolutely, in this case it was we provided the templates, and now we're looking to the next step of, because in the system today we have two or three templates that is for leaders, for white collar and blue collar. That's basically very, very streamlined and easy. But if you work, or if you're into recruitment, you provide your recruitment job profile, and based on that, maybe we look for a salesperson, for instance. And then it's important to be networking. I'm a networking person. I probably need to be quite extrovert to be able to convince you to buy our products, mm-hmm. etc. And that's something that when you put the profile, you should work with that with all within the whole recruitment process. So you interview based on that profile, you do maybe test or assessments based on that. And also when you do the reference checking, you use the information or the requirements that you put in the profile, mm-hmm. in what type of questions you should ask. So basically you can make based on how many type of roles that you recruit on your company, you can have a different type of profiles in your system. But we see that our clients don't really do that. They use our templates, and that's something we would like to help now, mm-hmm. in the future as well.
Which takes me to the second thought of this article. And you said when you send out the reference, what I took from this article is you actually invite the candidate, him or herself, into the process.
Yeah.
So he or she basically in the system puts in whoever is the reference and when this person should be contacted, or that they are actually in charge of timing, possibly. Or how does that look?
Yeah, or not if you have an automated workflow, the reference checking email and text message goes right away when the candidate put in the...
When you hit that level, basically.
Okay. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, right. That's true. Yeah. And that's, I see what you're coming, what you're asking about, and that is, who is the referees then? Could you be sure that it's the right referees? Mm. And absolutely, that is something we discuss with our clients all the time, that put demand on the candidate what type of referees you would like to have. Mm-hmm. Don't just accept whoever he or she think is the best referees. It should be a discussion that the candidate and the recruitment manager or the recruiter have based on what happened in the process. Now we come to the reference checking. What more do I need to make my decision? Mm. All right, maybe during the interview we discussed a project that was a little bit fuzzy. Can I have a referees within someone from that project, the project manager, someone else in the project that you work with? Because that is important to justify that we have the right type of references based on what we want to have, what would like to get out of the actual reference checking. You understand what I mean?
Yeah, definitely. To get to the real core of it. Yeah. Or to the real core of what you're looking for. You're actually brainstorming or ball bouncing with a reference giver. Yeah. So he also, Eric also writes about within 40 hours of this first successful reference taking, he had all the references in the system.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, and that's, we of course track that, and that's pretty much the average based on when you make the collection from the candidate. If you just collect the data from when the referee get the information or get the email or text message about being a referee, then our general time would be 12 to 14 hours based on blue collar workers, where the questionnaire is quite short and we inform about that. And when it's more white collar or specialist recruitment, it's up to 24 hours when you collect the information. So I think it's the time to hire we usually talk about in recruitment. How long does it take for you to hire the candidate based from today? Day one, we put up the requirement, and last day we sign the contract. And reference checking can be very, very time consuming based on we don't get in contact with the referee. We don't, everything is smooth if he or she answer on the first phone.
Which but
that's not the word. That's not the reality. Sorry.
So listen, David, we've been covering quite a lot on the process.
Yeah. Right?
which is super intriguing for HR or recruitment people. But let's, I mean, there is a lot of ethical sides on recruitment reference taking as well. I wanted to hear what you've been covering a bit about backdoor references in your articles. What does that mean?
Yeah, backdoor reference is where you contact a referee that is not informed to the actual candidate. The candidate is not informed that you will talk or discuss the candidate with someone else.
You so check with a friend or something that you know been working with the same company, something like this.
Exactly, because in your industry, the network is quite slim. Probably the manager knows another manager that's been the manager for the developer or whatever the recruitment is.
Yeah.
And then it's so easy to just lift the phone. Hello, you work with this person before. Is it good or not?
I've been doing it many times, David.
Yeah, you do that. Yeah. And I don't blame you for that. But what we need to think about is, what is the reaction from the candidate? Is he or she open about looking for a new job? Yeah, yeah. When it comes to developers, it's quite, there are a lot of developers that are contacted by recruiters. So I think it's not that ethical to do that way based on it could be it could be ruining for the candidate if it appears that he or she is in another process.
Yeah.
But also when it comes to, is this really a good reference for this type of job?
Exactly.
Because whoever you are in contact with, maybe not is the best person to judge this candidate based on what the candidate is looking for in the new job. So, but what I see is that be open with it, with the candidate. Say that I see you, we have a friend in common here, or I work with that, your former manager. Is it okay that I do reference checks with him as well, him or her as well? And based on the answer from the candidate, then it could be a really interesting discussion if he or she says no, I don't want to have that that person as a referee. Have a discussion about that, and I would say when I've done that with some candidates, I would say I got a lot of the candidate becomes quite open about the situation. We had a fight, and we could discuss that in a professional way, and that's very good, I think. So, don't use backdoor references, but of course you should provide referees that you think is good for this project, and have a discussion with the candidate based on that. Then,
so make use of your network and your connections, absolutely, but do it transparently.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So, great.
What's the most? I'm thinking I'm rounding up here a bit.
Yeah, okay, great.
What's the worst question that you see or have seen in reference checks?
Yeah. And this is also one way of why I think we've grown so fast. Because when I speak with HR, when the recruitment manager is doing reference checks, they are quite afraid of what's happening in that call. They cannot control it. And I actually heard from HR the other week. No, it's not the other week. It's probably 1 year ago. But she said that I over-listened that call, and I heard the recruitment manager ask the referee if the candidate would be an animal, what animal should that be? That's in some way it might be an interesting question, but it has nothing to do with the actual job. It has nothing to do with the requirement profile. So yeah, that wasn't a good question, I would say.
So if I ask
and
you now,
that happens a lot. The HR managers that I talk to says that not maybe that type of question, but it also is important that you are not being judgeful or do put illegal questions. Like you cannot ask every question that you would like to ask. I also heard someone ask the candidate was a woman in the 30s. Of course, an interesting question could be: is she pregnant or in some way being pregnant soon? And you shouldn't ask those type of questions. That shouldn't be in the decision making for you. Then it's judgeful. Yeah.
Now that's officially taboo now.
After it, I would say.
Yeah, but might very well happen still. We might have a long way to go.
Yeah, in our network, the HR, they are really aware of this, and then they try to educate the managers about that. But it's a slippery slope.
What's the most common question?
Oh, the most common question is probably also the best question, I would say. How would you rate this candidate compared to others that did similar work? I think that's a good question to just make sure, because that is one big thing about, one important thing about why we do reference checks, is that we really want to have this second opinion, to have a check that the candidate is good. And I would like to check that with someone else. Was the candidate successful in his or her last job? So I would say most common and the best question. Yeah.
You might like the person very much as a person, but job-wise, rates.
Exactly, because it is job-wise that we are doing recruitment, hopefully.
What do you think we should know more than what we have not covered?
No, we can talk a few hours about this. I'm really into this, but no, I think we covered the most. It's a lot about the process, a little bit of backdoor references, of course. You can always dig into more about the problems with digital reference checks that you don't have actually the contact. You cannot ask a specific follow-up question, but our client says that it's because we have in the system it's possible to ask one extra question based on the answer, but and then I of course got a lot of questions, but if I want some more follow-up questions, but our client says that we don't need that, and when we need that, of course, we lift the phone or book a phone call and follow up whatever was missing in the written reference checks. But I think it's the way of doing this, it gets more structured. You get really exactly what the referee says, because when I did reference checks, I wasn't the manager. I was a recruitment
The middleman.
I was the middleman. So my I was doing the reference checks, and then I did some whispering, in Sweden we call it a whispering game
whispers. I think it's
Chinese whispering. Yeah, okay,
like
great.
Half of the message is actually not getting through.
Yeah, and actually the 50%, there are a lot of studies about this that we cannot, our brains are 40,000 years old. We cannot, if we don't record the actual phone call, and I don't think that the manager would like to repeat the phone call, you lose 50% of the information, and that's a big problem.
So now everyone actively part of the process, the recruitment process, gets the message straight away.
Yeah, from the very transparent. Mouth. This is exactly what the referee said. Of course, if I'm not happy with the report, maybe I do take some extra referees, because that's also it's not that time consuming for the referees. So maybe you can collect some more referees. And that's also important to increase the validity. If we have a few more referees than we usually have, I would say two referees is the normal in the Nordics anyway. But based on our system and what science says, we should do at least three, probably five and more. You're more the merrier. So with a digital tool, that's not a problem.
Because it's so very simple.
Yeah, and then you get more of a Yeah, it's like statistics. You more data you have, you more information. That in your business, that's very important. And in our business as well. So the more answers I can get, and if I do it in some way mechanical based on a scaling question, for instance, 1 to 5 questions, if I see 5 different referees ask on the answer on the same question with a scaling question, I could be quite sure that the behavior from the candidate is like that. And that's a problem when I call someone and I don't know if that was the right behavior based on one data point.
Exactly. Okay, so sum it up. we've been talking about the time efficiency. We've been talking about the candidate being sort of active in the process. We've been talking about quick returns of references. And what did you say? 6% of people wanting to do phone calls rather than digital solutions.
Yeah. So they always have the ability to book a phone call with their recruiter or recruitment manager, and vice versa. Also, the recruiter are able to send out an email about time suggestions. These are the time suggestions that I have for a phone call, but
less aggressive, not that common. Basically.
Yeah.
Exactly. We've been covering the ethical part. Do use your network, but don't do backdoor references. Note to self. I don't think I'm alone in backdoor references.
No
more, David. I promise you.
Thank you.
And also, we covered a few questions. And I think that this is a golden point where we can end this discussion by seeing how really bad the question is. David, what animal are you?
I'm probably
you're the candidate now.
What do you think? Yeah, quite fat. So probably something big, a beer or something. Bear. I drink a lot of beers, but not.
So then we are supposed to have a discussion about why you're a bear. Yeah, I see why absolutely. That's a very bad question.
Yeah, I'm quite extrovert, and I like to eat blueberry.
Okay, very good. There you go.
Maybe
okay. More references needed. David, it's
absolutely.
Been amazing having you.
Thank you, Heidi.
Good luck with
Great call. Great conversation.
Very good Thank conversation. You. Very good conversation. Let's stay in contact.
We do.
Awesome. And enjoy the fantastic weather in Gothenburg.
Yeah, now it's raining. As it usually does. Yeah.
Awesome.
All right. Thank
Take
you,
care.
Heidi.
Vi ses. Vi hörs.
Bye.
Ciao.